The most well-known heuristic for graph partitioning is the Kernighan-Lin algorithm. By the way, the G in Kernighan is silent. That's new as in the wildebeest, not the free software thing, which has a hard G, as in GNU. So it's new, not GNU. Got it? The idea behind the KL algorithm is simple. Given a graph, divide the vertices into two subsets of equal or nearly equal size. Yes, any split will do. I'm serious, anyone you want. It's okay, go ahead. Oh, for goodness sake, just pick a partition already. Let's define the cost of this partitioning to be the number of edges that go between V1 and V2. Now, imagine that a magic bean hands you two equal sized subsets of V1 and V2. Let's call these subsets X1 and X2. Imagine that you were to swap these two subsets. Naturally, you'd expect the cut size to change. But by how much? To answer this question in a formal way, let's start with some definitions. Consider one vertex, let's call it A, which lives on one side of a partition. Define its external cost as the number of edges that land in the other partition. In this cartoon, A's external cost, denoted E1 of A, is equal to 3 edges. Define a similar external cost, E2 of B, for any vertex B that lives in V2. Next, define the notion of an internal cost. The internal cost will count the number of edges from a vertex to other vertices that live in the same partition. From these definitions, you can write down the cost of a partition as follows. It's the cost of the partition ignoring A and B, plus the external cost of A, the external cost of B, and minus some constant. So what's this constant? You need that constant to account for a possible edge between A and B. The constant is 1 if there's an edge there and 0 otherwise. But why subtract it? Ah, that is a terrific question, and you should take a moment to ponder it. Now suppose you swap A and B. What's the new cost? Well, any edge that was incident on A that was previously external is now internal. Same thing goes for B. So to get the new cost, let's start with the old cost ignoring A and B, and then add some adjustments. The adjustments involved the internal costs of A and B, plus the constant again. Hey, what's with the plus constant now? Now let's look at the change in cost. That's the old cost minus the new cost. After some algebra, you get this. The larger this change, the better, because it means a larger decrease in the cost. Let's call this cost the gain from swapping A and B. By the way, do you see that it's possible that gain of AB could actually be negative,